Thank you.
of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments dwell the law and the prophets.
The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light. Yes,
Give us grace, O Lord, to answer readily the call of our Savior, Jesus Christ, and proclaim to all people the good news of his salvation, that we and the whole world may perceive the glory of his marvelous works, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Reading from Paul's first epistle to the church of Corinth, beginning in the 7th chapter, the 17th verse. Only let everyone lead the life which the Lord has assigned to him, and in which God has called him. For this is my rule in all the churches. Was any at one time of his call already circumcised? Let him not seek to remove the marks of circumcision. Was any one at the time of his call uncircumcised? Let him not seek circumcision. For neither circumcision counts for anything, nor uncircumcision, but keeping the commandments of God. Everyone should remain in the state in which he was called. Were you a slave when called? Never mind. But if you can gain your freedom, avail yourself of the opportunity. For he who is called in the Lord as a slave is a freedman of the Lord. Likewise, he who was free when he was called is a slave of Christ. You were bought with a price. Do not become the slaves of men. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will give thanks unto thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth righteousness.
According to St. Mark.
Glory be to God.
after John was arrested, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of God, and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." And passing along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, the brother of Simon, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going on a little farther, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who were in their boat, mending the nets. And immediately he called to them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired servants and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
You were bought with a price. Do not become slaves of men. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
When I was a young man living and working in Washington, D.C., working on Capitol Hill, there was an axiom that was pretty much known by everybody that went around town among all the policymakers and the important people who lived and worked there. And it went like this: where you stand depends on where you sit. Where you stand depends on where you sit. And what that meant was is that your position on any particular policy matter or spending matter, it all was determined on where you were working, where you were serving. Were you in the administration? Were you in a particular government agency? Did you work in the House or in the Senate? Were you a Republican or a Democrat? All of that would determine where you stood on a particular issue. And if you look at life in general, sometimes that's true for other parts of life, not just Washington, D.C. Like, for example, what's your position on being grounded? If you're a parent, you're all for it. But if you're the teenager, you're not really very excited about it, right? But here's the thing. Jesus says, none of that matters because we sit with him. So we always stand with him no matter where we are. And Paul, in his letter to the Corinthians today, really gets into this idea that when we become a Christian, that doesn't mean that our social standing, our place in society necessarily is going to change. Because you see, in Paul's time, when people started converting to Christ and becoming Christians and joining the church, some of them would come and say, you know, is it all right if I divorce my unbelieving spouse? Or if I'm a slave, is it all right if I, you know, leave my master and run away and become a free person? And Paul says, no, that's not it. He says, only let everyone lead the life which the Lord has assigned to him and in which God has called him. And so what Paul is saying here is that your circumstances in your life, that you're married to so-and-so, that you live in such and such a town, that you work in such and such a business, all of those circumstances have all been determined by God. God's the one in charge of your circumstances, and he's the one that's put you exactly where you are, and so where you are is where you're supposed to be. So don't go look to change it. Instead, Paul says, what's happened now that you've become a Christian is that your insides are being changed by Christ, that your motivations, your ultimate loyalties have changed. Now, what are we taught in society? We're taught to be loyal, you know. When we're good employees, we're taught to be good employees and be loyal to our bosses. We're told to be loyal to our spouses, be loyal to our families. And you know what? All that is fine as far as it goes. But once we become a Christian, once we give our lives to Jesus Christ, then something happens. And it's, you could almost say it's kind of subversive, because nothing clearly happens on the outside. That is to say, my social standing doesn't change, but my motivations are different. Now, my ultimate loyalty is to Jesus Christ, and my loyalty to him trumps every other loyalty that I have. Whether it's loyalty to my country, loyalty to my spouse, loyalty to my family, loyalty to my boss, my loyalty to Jesus Christ supersedes all those other loyalties. So therefore, what we are called to do then is to be Christians wherever God has put us. We follow Jesus Christ no matter where we are, what we're doing. So if I'm working on Capitol Hill, I'm loyal to the member I work for, but my ultimate loyalty is to Jesus Christ. If I'm married to an unbelieving spouse, my loyalty is still to my spouse, even though we don't yet agree on who's Savior and Lord, but my ultimate loyalty is to Jesus Christ. If I'm an employer at a company, my loyalty is to my boss, but my ultimate loyalty is to Jesus Christ. So I begin then to see things in a different way. I'm no longer working simply to please my spouse or please my boss, or please my political allies, whatever, whoever they may be. Ultimately, I'm working to please Jesus Christ, and it's his pleasure, his approval, that I'm seeking all the time. And you know, the great thing is, I can live for Jesus no matter what office I find myself in. Whether I'm single, married, whether I'm working in the White House or working at the Union Gospel Mission, everywhere I go, no matter who I'm with, no matter what I'm doing, everything that I do for Jesus Christ. And so we come to our gospel lesson for today, and we see Jesus calling his first disciples, and he says to them, follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men. And immediately they left their nets and followed him. Now, people have looked at that and said, well, you know what? If I become a Christian, that means I should quit my job and go into full-time ministry. Well, no, it doesn't mean that. You might be called to full-time ministry, and God will make that clear to you over time. But it is clear that when Jesus calls us, our call to follow him is not dependent upon our particular circumstances. We follow him no matter what our circumstances are, no matter where we find ourselves. And you know what? We're called to be fishers of men, whether we're priests or bishops or congressmen or senators or the president of the United States or parishioners here at St. Timothy's. No matter where we are, no matter what we're doing, the call is always the same, to follow Jesus Christ, to love him, to serve him, to be fishers of men. You see, now that we belong to Jesus, it means that we now answer to him. As Paul says, you were bought with a price. Do not become slaves of men. So, my friends, we're not slaves to the expectations of others. Our goal is not to simply meet the expectations of others. Our goal, our purpose, is to respond to Jesus' call and follow him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Power and the glory, now and forever.
repent you of your sins and are in love and in charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may thereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn to him, have mercy upon you, pardon, and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ says to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, O ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he's the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Great to see you all this morning. It's great to be back. Last week I was out because I went to a funeral up in Wichita, Kansas. A close friend of mine, his father passed away, and the family asked me to do the funeral, so it was a great honor. So I'm sorry I missed you all last week. And the week before, I was hung up with moving snafus. I was supposed to move on Saturday, and that didn't happen. Then I was supposed to move on Sunday, and then that was canceled because of the snow, and so I ended up sitting at home waiting for the snow to stop last Sunday. So it's really great to be back with you all today. Really great. I have moved into my new house, so I give praise God for that. My dog is very happy because now he's got a backyard to play in and he's got a doggy door. So he's very happy about all of that. So just want to give you a heads up about what's coming up here. Next week, next Sunday, the 31st, we're going to be having our annual parish annual meeting, and we're going to do that both in person and via live stream.
Zoom.
So via Zoom. So we would love it if you can participate with us. We're going to send out the information for that, and that will start at 11:15 next Sunday, and hopefully that'll give us enough time to have Mass at 9:30 and then finish that and then gather for our annual meeting at 11:15, and we'll have a presentation from our bishop in residence and from our senior warden and myself, so we get a sense of what God is calling us to do and to be here in 2021. And then, as I mentioned in my sermon, really call of God extends to all of us, no matter what place we find ourselves in. The call to follow Jesus is always the same, to follow him, to serve him, to be fishers of men. And that's what we're going to do, COVID or no COVID, in 2021. Then also, I want to remind you, February 2nd was just a few days after that. So that'll be Tuesday next week. Next Tuesday next week, we'll celebrate the Feast of the Purification of the Blessed Virgin Mary and the Presentation of Christ in the Temple. So we will have Mass at 9:30 at the Shrine, and then 7 o'clock here in the main church. And we'll have blessings at the candles. So Sunday the 31st, annual parish meeting. Tuesday, February 2nd, Feast of the Presentation. And then also, Lent is coming up, February 17th, that's Ash Wednesday. And our first Stations of the Cross will be on Friday the 19th. And we're going to talk about that some more as we go on. And of course, also this week, on Wednesdays, we'll have Mass in the Shrine, followed by Bishop Ackerman's Bible study. That'll be on Zoom at 10:45. Anything else, Kay, that I need to mention?
The instructions have gone out already for the annual meeting, so if you haven't received them and need help with Zoom, give us a call at the parish office and we'll be happy to help you.
Okay. So yeah, just we did send out instructions, but if you need some help with that, please call Kay and she will help you get connected. Anything else? Okay. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
He that is called in the Lord is Jesus of Christ.
We not be the servants of men, for ye are
thank you.
brethren, may this, my sacrifice and yours, be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
Remembrance of me.
Therefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we, and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion, may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and may one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. Remember also, O Lord, thy servants and handmaidens, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and are at rest in the sleep of peace. To these, O Lord, and to all who rest in Christ, we beseech thee to grant a place of refreshment, of light, and of peace. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, and to commend these our prayers and supplications through the ministry of thy holy angels to be brought up into thy holy tabernacle before the sight of thy divine majesty, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father,
world without end. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof.
But speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men.
we most heartily thank thee, for thou hast vouchsafed to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, who has called us to a goodly heritage of the faith once delivered unto the apostles, we humbly beseech thee that thou wouldst give us that same zeal of the holy apostles and of our patron Saint Timothy, and at the intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin and all the saints, and by the outpouring of thine Holy Ghost, our parish may see its borders extended, both in heart and mission, and that thy kingdom may be extended to the glory of thy holy name. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who livest and reignest with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Of peace of God, which passeth all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds with the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with us.
Comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh,
and dwelt among us.
And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.
Depart in peace.
Amen.